Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to prepare and decorate your room for fall. I know we're already in October, but there's still November and the whole October, and you guys can use this for next year and the years after that. A lot of this is DIYs, but some of this is so easy that I wouldn't even consider it DIYs. Everybody can do this. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and don't forget to put down comments, questions, requests, opinions you might have, and let's dive right into the video. Alright guys, so for the first one is these jars with candles. So all you need is mason jars, some candles that you can shave off until you fit, and then fill up the jars with fillings. But if you want to see the full tutorial, then click on the link in the video right here. For the second one, I just bought some burlap and it was a total of $3 at Michael's, and I just put it on my bookshelf. You can also put this on your dresser or on your table, and they have them with lace or with writing, but I thought this was appropriate enough and it adds a fall feeling. Next is this leaf garland, and all you need is some rope, some leaves, and some clips, or you can just punch holes in the leaves and then put the twine through. I got my leaves for $1.99 at Michael's, and then I just gathered them in bunches and put them onto my rope. You can also, of course, use real leaves that you get from outside, and I used push pins to pin it to my bookshelf. This one is super easy, but if you have makeup or you store pencils, you can fill up the jars with fall fillings, and I get them at Michael's, or you can get them at like Home Goods or Pier 1, and that's it. Alright, then you can again use mason jars and again use the fillings. And then also you can buy a bouquet at Michael's or, I don't know, Ross or Walmart. They have them in different places, the dollar store. And then I cut off the stems to make them shorter, put them in bunches and secured it with some elastic hairbands, and then just stuck them into my mason jars. So I don't look like the mother bitches. Lift them drinks, yeah, that's my fitness. Fuel to the fire, fuel to the fire. Alright, so the next one is a DIY, and I got this wooden crate at Michael's. Again, I get everything from Michael's, but I did not like the writing on it, so I covered it in black and wrote fall instead of friends, because welcome fall made more sense to me. So that was really easy, and then I took gold metallic paint and covered the top of the crate as well. Alright, for this next one, I got pine cones at a park. They were free, obviously. And then I used different color schemes. So for example, for my blue one, I used dark blue, light blue, and then white. And then I painted the tips of the pine cone. And basically, I started with a dark blue, and then about one-third of the way, I switched to lighter blue, and then I switched to white for the very top, and this gave him an ombre look. And then I did the same thing with reds and greens, and I think I even did like a black gray and white one. So this is what they look like when they were done. I think this was my favorite out of all of these. It looked so cool and like kind of really cute, and I put them into my crate afterwards. You can also add like different oils or extracts, like, I don't know, vanilla or pumpkin or something, to give it a smell, and then your room will stay smelling nice because the pine cones absorb that well. This one is super easy. All I took was my old candles and my old socks that I never wore because I didn't like them for some reason. And I cut off the bottoms and I just stuck that onto the candle. That is it. Okay, so after buying all that burlap, you have a lot left over, and what you can do with it is make wreaths, and here's the full video. You can click on it to watch it. It's really easy, under $13 for one wreath, but then like under $16 for two, and it's really pretty. I think it's amazing. I also did paint a pine cone a full metallic blue and added that to my dresser. You can also do things like hang scarves around your room or add a lot of blankets and pillows, which definitely contributes to a fall feeling. Alright you guys, so this is it for this day's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it's pretty late and it's already the end of, or like more than the middle of October, but I hope you can use this for next year, and we still have November, so some of these will definitely still contribute to November. You can still keep them up. Anyways, I hope you guys liked it. Please put down comments, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe. I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys!